Political commentator Karima Brown joins us now. Perhaps it was more interesting as to what was happening outside. I went to Script Insight today, and this is what he said, Jacob Zuma. There would come a time when those advocating for his prosecution will wish the matter was never brought to the courts. Is he unleashing the dogs of war there?
Look, this is not new. President Jacob Zuma has historically gone around when he's in trouble, saying that the day will come when all will be revealed. Remember, in the run-up to NASREC, he addressed various CADIS forums, and he did exactly the same thing.
But these words today will have more import, I'm
no,
sure.
Absolutely. And I think we need to look at it connected to the fact that he said that those he trusted are now not supporting him. I think this is a man deeply at odds, Jeremy, with his own organization. The African National Congress has formally taken a decision to not provide him with any kind of political support. Now, for someone like Jacob Zuma, who's been in the African National Congress for over 65 years, that is a deep, deep wound. And you could see that. There were loads of people outside the ANC, outside the courts with ANC regalia. But the truth of the matter is, these were people that were not actually as a part of the main cadres of the organization. If you look at an organization such as Black First, Land First, it is an organization that was funded, aided, and abetted by the Gupta family for state capture. That's got nothing to do with the history of the organization that the African National Congress former President Jacob Zuma has spent his whole life in. These are the people that had to come out and bat for him. And he's wounded. He's deeply wounded. He's angry. And he lashed out today. And of course, he's always threatened to spill the beans. And the irony of the matter, of course, is that he spent 10 years trying to avoid getting to a place where he can tell his side of the story. And of course, he's again today trying to push the matter back by trying to go for a review of the case.
And politically, Karima, it's hugely risky for Luthuli House, because on the one hand, they've got to weigh up the potential damage that he could cause, particularly within KwaZulu-Natal and his support base. On the other hand, we have an election next year.
Yes. Look, I think what the African National Congress has done formally is in fact spot on. They have argued that no one is above the law and that there is respect for the rule of law and of course respect for the independence of the judiciary. And that's an important point, because the idea here that there's a political prosecution against President Jacob Zuma, the way people like Carl Niels and others want to suggest, is premised on something that is fundamentally false. We are not in apartheid South Africa. This is our democracy. This judiciary belongs to a democratic South Africa, and President Jacob Zuma has to subject himself, like everyone else, to that. If one argues that he is the victim of a political prosecution, then you obviously questioning the very basis of this democracy, which President Jacob Zuma is on record as having praised. So I think the ANC is walking that fine line very well. I think what is backfiring for them, Jeremy, was this idea that paraphernalia, that colors and so on can't be used. That is just something that you shouldn't do, because people ignore that anyway.
It was inevitable.
It was absolutely inevitable. But there is no serious commentator that can claim that the African National Congress was outside the court today supporting President Jacob Zuma. That didn't happen. And he made that clear. He was bitter, he was angry, he was wounded that the organization that he spent his life in wasn't there for him.
We have judges in 2008 and 2018. Many of Jacob Zuma's supporters are talking about the integrity of the judiciary. One expects that they would say that. But whoever eventually presides over this, it's going to be hugely pressurized for them. But it will also, again, put a firm spotlight on South Africa's, the independence of South Africa's judiciary.
Absolutely. And I think, Jeremy, it is not a problem for South Africans to debate various arms of state and to talk about its efficacy and whether it serves the purpose. But we need to contextualize this. If we look at what preceded this case, the process around state capture, and the fact that it was the judiciary that often reminded President Zuma when he was president that he had, in fact, violated his oath of office, reminded Parliament that they didn't do enough enough to actually hold him to account, then you can see that the record of the judiciary is such that their performance is exemplary. This idea of judicial overreach also is often used loose and fast, but of course one has to look at what the rulings of the court is, because therein lies the detail of whether or not they are actually doing their jobs. And we have yet to see a substantial case where there has been issues of overreach. So people need to stick to the facts, and of course people need to separate this talk of conspiracy that President Jacob Zuma loves and thrives in, and what is actually happening.
Easier said than done, though, Karima, in this highly charged political environment. So we now wait for June 8, which is the next court appearance. Karima, thank you very much indeed. Now let me